Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for November 2018 to January 2019. Drier and warmer than average conditions are likely to persist for much of Australia over the coming months. And we've raised our ENSO Outlook to El Niño Alert. First, let's look at recent conditions. Following dry conditions for much of 2018, including Australia's driest September on record, some places have had heavy rains in October. Isolated severe thunderstorms along the east coast caused damage with large hail and strong winds. Some locations had 2 to 3 times their October rainfall in a week, but others have missed out on any significant falls. But overall, recent rains have made little difference to totals over the critical April to October southern cropping season, which is still on track to be one of the 10 driest seasons on record. Serious and severe rainfall deficiencies persist for large parts of New South Wales and Queensland. Severe deficiencies also continued in the west, where strong winds blowing over dry soils resulted in dust storms. Temperatures in October have been warmer than average across much of Australia. Tasmania's on track for one of its warmest Octobers on record. Warmer than average days over the whole cropping season have contributed to record evaporation in eastern Australia. Soil moisture across most of Australia continues to be below average. Poor winter rains meant a late start and early end to the water storage filling season in many areas. Compared with September, storage levels dropped slightly in October in areas where they would normally still be increasing. So what's influencing our climate in the coming months? In the Indian Ocean, recent sea surface temperatures show a borderline positive Indian Ocean dipole. In the tropical Pacific, trade winds have weakened, warming the ocean. As a result, we've raised our ENSO outlook to El Niño Alert. A positive IOD and El Niño in spring would typically increase the likelihood of a dry and warm end to the year. Our rainfall outlook combines the influences from all our current climate drivers. The November to January outlook suggests much of Australia is likely to be drier than average. Turning to stream flows, with below average rainfall likely and dry soils, low stream flows are expected at nearly 90% of forecast locations for October to December. Temperatures for November to January are very likely to be above average over most of Australia. Australia's tropical cyclone season typically begins in November. This year's outlook suggests fewer tropical cyclones than usual are likely to form in our region. But Australia has always had at least one tropical cyclone cross the coast each season. So those who live in areas affected by tropical cyclones should be prepared. So in summary, rainfall is likely to be below average in most areas. Temperatures are likely to be warmer than average. Low stream flows are forecast for much of Australia. And we're likely to see fewer tropical cyclones than normal. For more details, visit our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter. Our first look at likely conditions for summer will be available on Thursday, the 15th of November. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Felicity Gamble.